All right, guys, let's start our spring cleaning challenge. So today we're going to talk about Tupperware. So obviously it's simple. You just need to pull out all your Tupperware, get rid of the ones that are mismatched or not usable anymore, keep your favorites, reduce the number you have, and put them back neatly in the cupboard, right? That's what it boils down to. But if you want a more in-depth step-by-step process to kind of help you think through what you're going to keep and what you're going to get rid of, click on the blog post and I talk a lot more about it there. This is just a little quick thing to get you started. So spend a few minutes addressing that area and I will show you a couple of tips here that work for me. So I like to keep my Tupperware in a bin because we have old cabinets that don't have slide outs, so things tend to get lost in the back. So I just have a little canvas bin, kind of a cheapy thing, from the dollar store that I keep them in. You could use even a shoebox. So I like to keep the Tupperwares and the lids in here. I can kind of stack them. I can just toss them in there. They don't have to be super organized, because if there's a manageable number of them, they don't get too messy. It's fairly easy to find what I need. I like to use containers that stack inside each other. That makes it easier to make use of the space. If I have an odd one that doesn't fit, sometimes I'll just get rid of it because it makes things harder. So I keep ones that fit together. For my bigger Tupperwares that I use, like for leftovers and cut up fruit and things, I have upgraded to Pyrex glass ones that have lids that snap right on. They are amazing. I love them. They go from the fridge to the microwave to the table, and they're awesome. So there's a link to those in the blog post where you can get those. But the lids all live in here and they're easy to find. I have one other little bin here where I keep smaller Tupperwares that I use for packing school lunches because we pack 3,000 school lunches a week approximately. So they're all in there too. They're just tossed in there. They're not organized, but it makes it easy for people to find what they need and for to put the clean dishes away. If I had them stacked in there in a neat little organizing system, that might work for some people. For us, it doesn't work because if other people other than me were to put the dishes away, they're just gonna get thrown in there and not put in the right spot. I don't want to be the mom that's freaking out that the Tupperwares aren't stacked up, so it's fine if we just toss them in there because there's a limited number of them, so that makes it easier to find things, if that makes sense. So I just shove my bins back in there and it simplifies it just a little bit. Makes that area work a little bit better without having it to be super duper organized or anything like that. I do stay on top of it and get rid of things periodically if there gets to be too many. Through this process, if you come across things that you don't need or that you're ready to part with, you don't have to worry about getting rid of them today. Set them aside in a box, put that box in your bedroom or garage or basement or something. At the end of this whole challenge, we're going to address what to do with all of those things that we've purged, and we'll talk about different ways that you can get rid of those because sometimes just the actual getting rid of things can be difficult too. So we'll talk about that later. Don't worry about it today. Just do the Tupperware. So when you're done with that, if you feel good about it and if you feel energized by it, you can move on to something else if you want. Pat yourself on the back for the job you did. But if you want to do something more, you can use the same process for like coffee mugs or baking pans or something else that is another clutter spot for you. Or you can look on our blog. We have a few other videos talking about other kitchen tips, specifically ways to make your kitchen work harder if it's a small kitchen or an old kitchen, because sometimes those can be a struggle when you don't have as much functionality as some of those new kitchens have. So you can feel free to look at those too. And if you want to work ahead, if you have extra time today to do a bunch of challenges, you can look ahead on the blog and do some other challenges in other rooms too, if you're in the mood for spring cleaning today. So hopefully that's helpful. Click on the blog for more tips and step by step to guide you. So good luck in your decluttering.